What's up, guys? I have a new flagship smart ring from a Ring Icon company. It is called Ring Icon Gen 2. You know, I already tested the smart ring from Ultra Human some months ago, and I liked it, although it is quite expensive. The Ring Icon Gen 2 has the same $300 price tag, but it has some new features. For example, the manufacturer claims it is the first smart ring with a sleep apnea monitoring. It also has much longer battery life than Ultra Human Smart Ring, up to 12 days, and it is the thinnest and lightest smart ring with a minimum thickness of 2 mm, width of 6.8 mm, and weight of 2-3 grams. These are all the company claims, but we will check them out in this video. By the way, an entry-level version of this smart ring will be released in a couple of days, March 25th. While the Ring Icon Gen 2 Air looks the same as the flagship smart ring, it is more affordable, only $200. I don't have the Air version of the smart ring yet, but maybe later I will make a video about it. Let's go back to the Ring Icon Gen 2 and start the review by unboxing it. As usual, when ordering a smart ring, first you receive a sizing kit to find out what size of the ring you need. That's very important, because even if you have another smart ring, it might be a different size than this one. Smart rings have unique designs and shapes, so you need to use a sizing kit when ordering a new one. You can also see here the colors and materials available for the Ring Icon Gen 2. I will choose Future Silver. By the way, rose gold color is more expensive than the other three for $169. Once you know the size, you need to wait for the smart ring itself to be delivered to you. It comes in a similar box to the sizing kit, but now it has the image of the ring in different colors. On the back of the box, we can check the color and size of the smart ring. When you open the package, you will find the user manual and quick guide, the ring itself, a charging case, and a charging cable. Unlike the Ultra Human ring that I tested before, the Ring Icon Gen 2 comes not just with a charging dock, but a smart charging case. It has a capacity of 500 mAh, and you can use it to charge the ring. We will talk more about that a little later. So I have the Ring Icon Gen 2 smart ring in Future Silver color. As you can see, it is glossy and smooth. If you want a matte finish, then choose black color. The royal gold and rose gold are also glossy. The inside of the ring is black, and we can even see some of its hardware and sensors. By the way, the ring is not an even circle on the outside. It also has one of the sides inside flat, and there are some kinds of two small balls here. However, they do not bring any discomfort at all. But it's important to choose the right size, so that the ring will not be too small for you. You know, I read the user manual, and I couldn't find which finger is best to wear the ring on. I think you can use any finger. I'm more comfortable on index finger. Talking about materials of the Ring Icon Gen 2. It is made of metallic titanium on the outside and medical grade epoxy on the inside. You know, I have been wearing the ring now for 3 days, and I don't see any scratches or damage on it. By the way, during these 3 days, I never took off the ring. I washed my hands, took a shower, and I did everything else with the ring on my finger. The Ring Icon Gen 2 is IP68 and 1080m waterproof, which means it is water resistant to 100 meters or 328 feet. You can use it while exercising, swimming or showering, but you should take it off before visiting a sauna or a steam bath. The company claims that this is the lightest and the thinnest smart ring. We can even see the comparison of Gen 1 and Gen 2 on the official website. While a reduction of 1 gram in weight, 1 mm in thickness, and 0.66 mm in width doesn't seem impressive, it is really noticeable for a ring. compared to Gen 1, the new Smart Ring is 24.8% thinner, 33.3% lighter, and 12.8% narrower. The weight of the ring on Gen 2 is from 2 to 3 grams, depending on your size. I have a ring size 12, and it weighs 3 grams. But I don't think my scale is very accurate in measuring milligrams. Okay, we have talked about design, but what about functions? Since the Ringcon Gen 2 doesn't have a display like any other smart ring, all control, measurements, and other functions are performed in the mobile app. It is called Ringcon. You can download it on Android and iOS devices. As I said before, I have been using the smart ring for 3 days, and let's take a look at one of them. So first, we can see the wellness balance. It is used to assess the score for your overall physical and mental state for the day, based on your sleep, activity, relax, and vital status. I have really good vital status and activity. But relax status and especially sleep wish for better. Next, we see information about sleep. Although I slept for 6 hours and 43 minutes, the sleep efficiency is only 71%. Time asleep is normal. And time in bed is also normal, but sleep efficiency is low. There are also sleep stages, movement, heart rate, HRV, SpO2, skin temperature, respiratory rate, nap and sleep summary available in the app. As for activity for the day, I took quite a few steps, 12,500, and also burned a lot of calories, 588. We can also see all-day calories, standing time, activity intensity ratio, exercise record, and activity summary. The next metric in the app is stress. I don't have a problem with this, because it says normal. The Ringcon Gen 2 Smart Ring monitors stress level throughout the day. You know, it is logical that my stress is higher in the evening than in the morning. We can also see stress ratio, sleeping stress, and stress summary in the app. There are vital signs available in the app, such as heart rate, SpO2, HRV, skin temperature, and respiratory rate. I'm glad my stats are all good and that there are no significant or minor outliers. You can also use Ringcon Gen 2 Smart Ring to track your exercise. However, there are only 4 workout modes available, such as outdoor running, indoor running, outdoor cycling, and outdoor walking. You should understand that the ring doesn't have a built-in GPS, and it uses it from your smartphone, so you need to take your phone with you during your exercise. The last, but the unique feature of the Ringcon Gen 2 Smart Ring is sleep apnea monitoring. The ring actually needs to track your sleep for 3 nights to detect your problems. As you can see, no abnormalities detected on the first night, as well as second and third. After that, you can generate a comprehensive assessment report for sleep apnea risks. To be honest, I don't understand much here, but the main thing is that I don't have any problems. If you have any, you will see them here, and you can contact a sleep specialist to help you. The app also has an AI assistant that will tell you about sleep, activity, stress, etc. On the Trends tab, we can see historical data for the last 7 days. So I really like this app, because it is very intuitive. You can click on the exclamation mark on each metric and read more about it. However, I read in the user manual that this is not a medical device. Ringcon and related applications are not intended to diagnose, treat, cure, or prevent any disease or medical condition. Basically, just like any smart ring, smart watch, smart band, etc. You know, after this warning, I was interested in comparing the smart ring with a smartwatch. I have the Cosped watch that we have tested a couple weeks ago. It is not the most budget smartwatch, so it should have accurate measurements. Let's compare heart rate and SpO2 on the Ringcon Gen 2 Smart Ring and Cosped smartwatch, so the watch is much faster at measuring heart rate. But as you can see, they have identical BPM. As for SpO2, the Smart Ring measured blood oxygen saturation faster, but the readings are almost the same. I have come to conclusion that the Ringcon Gen 2 Smart Ring measures heart rate and SpO2 quite accurately. The battery life is another feature of the Ringcon Gen 2 Smart Ring, because the company promises up to 12 days on a single charge. When I first unboxed the ring and connected it to the app on my smartphone, the battery level was 97%. After 3 days of wearing the ring without taking it off, the battery level dropped to 69%. That means my ring should last at least 9 days, which is also great. Do not forget about the smart charging case. It has a battery capacity of 500 mAh and it provides more than 150 days of battery life. That's awesome! So honestly, I don't want to offend Ultra Human, but I liked the Ringcon Gen 2 Smart Ring better. Well, they are similar in design and comfort. Ringcon has a much better app. It's more intuitive and has more functions. In addition, Ringcon Gen 2 has one of the longest battery life of any smart ring, as well as a smart charging case. I would be interested in testing the new Ringcon Gen 2 Air and comparing it to this one. I hope I will be able to do that. By the way, I also have the Nova Smart Ring. Subscribe to our channel Tech Brothers, so do not miss a video about it. Thank you for watching. See you soon!